Our study is looking at the brain mechanisms that are thought to support auditory pitch perception and compares those mechanisms between old world macaque monkeys and humans, just to compare how the brains of these two species handle sound signals. And we discovered that the monkeys have very different mechanisms in their brains, a very different organization for handling sounds that we associate with pitch. So in a nutshell, what we found is that humans have a very strong bias in their cortex. Their brain responds very strongly to sounds that have a pitch quality to them compared to sounds that don't. On the other hand, monkeys don't. Monkeys seem to respond to sounds with pitch about the same, if not maybe a little worse, than the way their brains respond to sounds with noise. I think the nicest example was provided by my colleague and co-author on the paper, Sam Norman-Haignere, who describes, breaks down the pitch component and the noise component of speech. So when we speak, we have both those noise components and the pitch components, and you can isolate the two in whispering. So in whispering, you eliminate all of the pitch components, and you just have the kind of broadband noise, as it were, component here. And there are lots of aspects of human behavior that depend on pitch, most notably language, communication, and music, which are, in some sense, we think of as two uniquely human abilities. So we tested this by using a non-invasive technique called fMRI, or functional magnetic resonance imaging. We can use that as a measure of brain activity. Importantly, the sounds that we used were matched in frequency. So the low-level cue, that is just the frequency component, was matched for the pitched sounds and the non-pitched sounds. And the easy way to think about this is I can define a noise stimulus at any given frequency range, like I could versus those would be a low and a high frequency noise. And the pitched version of it might be oh and So I've got two different stimuli. They're either pitch stimuli or noise stimuli, and I can match them in terms of the efficacy of those stimuli to drive the auditory system itself. That is the frequency component. Could mean that the monkey's experience of the auditory world is very different from our own. You know, lots of animals have vocal sounds that make pitch and respond to pitched sounds. So birds and even macaque monkey calls, their vocalizations often have a pitch component to them. So we used an algorithm that allowed us to take macaque vocalizations, real recorded macaque vocalizations, and parse out the pitch components and the noise components. And then when we presented those stimuli, which presumably the macaque monkeys are very familiar with, we saw yet again that the humans showed a preference, much greater preference, for the pitched versions of the stimuli compared to the noise versions of the stimuli compared to the monkeys. So even then, the monkeys showed a little preference for the pitched versions of the stimuli, but the difference between the pitch and the noise was much higher in humans versus monkeys, which sort of suggests that, you know, the humans are more sensitive to the pitch quality of the macaque vocalizations than the macaques are themselves. What happens when you compare the sounds that have pitch, that is the ones that have these peaks, and the ones that don't have pitch within every given frequency range? And there, the pattern of results was just totally different between the species. So in humans, you see a lot of parts of the brain, that's this orange pattern, you see a lot of parts of the brain that show a lot of a greater activation to the sounds with pitch. In the macaque monkeys, you can see there's nothing. If anything, the macaque monkeys show a tiny little speck of blue, which shows that their brains responded more strongly to the sounds with noise than the sounds with pitch.